got a call from a neighbor about two blocks away who was trying to sell a story to a student newspaper chain across the country. Could I come and do one of my stunts with him? And I said, all right, as a favor, I'll come over with my beds and nails. And he shot it and he put it in the newspaper along with a short story. And some people at the Smithsonian Magazine saw it and said, hey, could we come and interview you and take some photographs? They were here for 3 days. And somebody at the Tonight Show, Rosemary Woods, read the Smithsonian Magazine and gave me a call and asked me to be on the show. She asked me 5 times. I said no the first 4 times because I was really afraid of it. But finally said yes, and it was wonderful. When I went to MIT, I didn't know what I was getting into. I was coming out of Fort Worth, Texas, and had never been on an airplane before. And here I am flying away far from home, and I'm there, and I'm competing with people that were at the top of their class in high school, and I wasn't at the top of my class. A lot of students were being drafted to Vietnam. They made me a full-time instructor, a junior instructor. I actually could vote with the faculty. And I was teaching 3 courses at a time by taking my own courses and, of course, not sleeping very much. But I really got turned on by teaching. In fact, my grades went from the lowest possible in my quantum mechanics class to an A because I started teaching. I started seeing purpose to education. A woman in my class named Sharon, she was doing really badly in general. One day she was taking a quiz from me and she came up to me afterwards. She said, Jearl, how come none of this has anything to do with my life? And I said, Sharon, this is physics. This is the clockwork of the universe. It has everything to do with your life. She looked at me straight and she said, give me an example. I could not come up with a single example. And it was that night I invented the flying circuits of physics because I knew the trouble with Sharon was the trouble with me. We had just seen chalkboard physics. But if you went outside the physics building into the real world, where's the physics? So I started writing down questions for Sharon, just for Sharon, like, why is the sky blue? Why is the sky blue during the day? Why is the sunset red? I wanted questions like that where you would go outside and see the physics. I wanted to teach as an instructor that somebody would, I could help them. You know, I don't have to just grade them. I wanted them to be smarter, wiser, and I wanted them to think about that physics class for the rest of their lives. The Kinetic Carnival was on the PBS satellite for a long time, back in the early days of PBS. So people all across the country saw it, and Canada too. It was very popular. And as you probably know, on days when a high school teacher maybe is not prepared as much as he or she should have been, they bring in the Kinetic Carnival and let the kids see that, and that everybody's happy. I wanted to do more video stuff about flying circus because I think it really sells physics. It is something that people will see in their everyday life. But I couldn't do it by myself. I cannot film myself. And somebody from the marketing department here at CSU came by one day and said, hey, how would you like to do some videos, short videos, maybe 1 to 3 minutes long? We'll shoot as many as you want. I said, okay, I'll try that. So I had professional help to set up cameras and lights, and I didn't have to do everything myself. I would have botched the job, and then it started to be fun. We had a lot of fun on it. There's no lack of new examples to do for another season of Flying Circus. The Flying Circus book has got thousands of ideas in it, and I see new stuff all the time. I see stuff, I ask myself, how does that work, you know? And then I can make a story out of it, and then a demonstration out of it. So there's no end to the number of Flying Circus episodes we could do. In fact, the original intention was to do hundreds of them, which we still might do. If I have one last thing to say to the audience, it's the same thing I say in all the videos at the end. Physics is everywhere, even in an interview.